Hello, my name is Laurel Papworth and I teach artificial intelligence. I'm a keynote speaker and things like that. In this video, we're going to use ChatGPT from OpenAI, create a chatbot and add it to our website so that people can ask questions of ChatGPT that has learned from within your website. So you'll be training the LLM, you'll be training GPT. It's really quick, really easy. I think it's less than 8 minutes. And we're using a free tool, which is even better. I suggest you do pay if you want more features, but to get started, try the free tool. Go to chatbase.co and click login in the top right. And on the bottom part of that screen, you'll see sign up. Just sign up. It's free. You can pay if you want, and I recommend that you do, but let's try the free account first to make sure it works for you. Go to My Chatbots menu, chatbase.co/my-chatbots, and click Create Chatbot. Now, at this point, you need to add sources. The one most people will use will be Add a Website. So put in the link to your website. If you prefer, you can put in your sitemap link, but most people will put in their website. If your website is too large, i.e. your eBay, it almost certainly will not be able to scrape the site in 120 seconds. So yeah, but for a normal small business, 2 minutes is fine. If you do have a big site or you find it's timing out, either speed up your website or contact Chatbase and tell them and they'll increase it for you. Click Create Chatbot. This will create the actual chatbot with the sources in it and give you access to the queries and the prompts based on your data sources, because now you're training ChatGPT on your website. When you're training an LLM, you need to give it a bit of time to pull everything in, make sure everything's correct. Then click on Settings to check the chatbot ID. You'll need this one, so remember where this is. You can change the name of the chatbot, so not the ID, but the actual name of the chatbot. Call it My Website or something, but just leave the base prompt as it is. The free version is GPT 3.5 Turbo, which will probably be enough for most websites most of the time. If you find that you want more accurate information, you have a lot of information, you have a lot of technical information, things like that, I would consider paying for the, I think it's $99 a month, the higher level subscription, and that will get you GPT-4. ChatGPT-4. Otherwise, 3.5 will be fine. Keep the chatbot private but embedded on a website. You can still add it to your website, but other people will not be able to access the chatbot from outside of the website, or the website that you approve. Now in the chat interface, you can change the welcome message. The default is, hi, what can I help you with? You may want to change it to something else. I added suggested messages. For instance, how do I contact Laurel Papworth, so that I could check them, make sure they work. I know what the popular questions are. It just saves time for everybody and it doesn't get ChatGPT, the chatbot, confused. I'll leave you to play with the menus, but if we go to the embed website menu, I'm going to copy and paste the second lot of code because I need to paste this into my website. I'm using WordPress. If you are using Shopify, then it will be very similar. The basic concept is we have to copy that code from Chatbase and paste it between the body tags on your website, whatever CMS, whatever content management system you're using. For WordPress, I go to Appearance, I go to Customs Groups, and then I'm pasting in where it says Add Scripts right after opening body tag, the code for my ChatGPT. And it will actually have the discrete number, it's not a number, it's a mixture of numbers and letters, for the chatbot ID, it's there twice. I will say that Chatbase has released a plugin for WordPress. I don't know if they've got one for Shopify and all the others, but when I tried the one for WordPress, it was very new and it didn't work for me. Now what I need to do is go to my website once everything's saved. And now when I refresh my website, the bottom right hand corner has a little, I've left it as the default, but it's black and white logo. How can I help you? P.S. Lowell says hi in waves. The person clicks, how can I contact Lowell Papworth? And then the chatbot came back with my phone number and my email address. It has powered by chatbase.co at the bottom. I don't care about that. It's a free version. If you are willing to pay, they'll remove that on one of the premium subscriptions. But that will get you up and running because it's actually ChatGPT pulling information from your website and providing a help customer service button for you. I hope you found that interesting. My name's Lowell Papworth. I'm an AI trainer and keynote speaker, available for private mentoring and corporate events. If you have any questions, please ask in the comments below. See you in the next tutorial. Bye.